Use this cutout to create a keyboard stand for those juicy pictures. Wait, what? This is actually, hold on. That's actually like pretty cool. The thing about keyboards that kind of sucks is that you don't get that little bit of control that you get with analog thumbsticks. You've got to like tap a key really lightly a whole bunch instead of being able to just push a stick forward ever so slightly to walk right up to the edge that you want to walk up to. So what I'm really excited about with this Wooting 2 HE keyboard is it's analog, which is really cool. Ooh. Sorry, I got distracted by the switches. They're all off, they're right here. That's it. No, here's the keycaps. Okay, so that sucks. I gotta install all the keycaps. Look, we got an accessory pack. We got a puller, a cable, and 4 switches. I gotta judge the cable too. Real bad. Oh!
Damn!
This is actually really impressive. Oh, the switches and the keycap puller. Yeah, they're great. I mean, but once you have like 5 of them. So these are the switches. These are those Lecker switches. So I guess they give you 4 replacements. Yeah, what I really wanna show you is the bottom of this thing. It's just got these little side clips, but no pins. Because it actually uses magnets. Get rid of this box. Oh, it's kind of cool though. There's like a little, you don't own a Wooting until you share it with others on our Discord or tag us on Instagram. Use this cutout. Use this cutout to create a keyboard stand for those juicy pictures. Wait, what? This is actually, hold on. You gotta see this. So you can like, yeah, can we get scissors? Because we can make a keyboard stand with this thing. Yeah, it's a serious pain that I have to actually cut this out because like the cardboard is, you know, it's thick. There you go. Very cool. Can we open it and just like flip it on?
Nope.
There's no way. Yeah, there's no way. So they come in like pretty stuck in. They use the same cross pattern on the top. So any keycaps that you have custom or just, you know, like JMK sets or whatever, you can put that from your keyboard onto this one. It's got like a little cable routing space down here. Ooh, and the blue stabilizers. Yeah, these stabs are look nice too. They're linear. So if you like clickies or tactile switches, it's not for you, sorry. It sounds okay. The real test though is like the space bar. Cause a lot of stabilizers just sound bad. Like, I don't know what it is, why people can't, ooh. I don't know if they've pre-lubed them or what, but they actually don't rattle. The overall sound is like pretty decent. It's a little too high pitched for me. I like a deeper like thock to it. Like a thock, I don't know. 185? Okay, so this thing is almost $200. It sounds okay for that price range. Like, I guess what you're really paying for is the analog feature on the switches. The layout's fine, it's your standard full keyboard. Flexes like a little bit, but it feels okay. The cool thing is you can actually change not the force, but like where it actuates. Okay, so we've got all our keycaps on, it sounds okay. Let's try plugging it in, but before I do, here's a message from our sponsor, Ridge Wallet. It's a compact wallet to keep your pant bulge down. You know, you gotta hate that. I don't even use a phone case on my phone to keep that down. It's got RFID blocking plates to keep everyone from stealing your info. They come in over 30 colors and styles, including carbon fiber and burnt titanium. Get 10% off and free worldwide shipping by using offer code CIRCUIT at ridge.com/circuit. Oh, it's got RGB now. Sorry, I'll try not to swear. I got a mouth like a sailor from working in a butcher shop for 3 years. Oh, what I do like is it shines through the clear housing on the switches really well. So I usually type about 120 words a minute at like 100% accuracy. It doesn't feel bad, it feels great. I'm just doing real bad. Yeah, that was terrible. 90 words a minute. Dirt, it's got dirt on here. So this is cool. It's not giving me keyboard prompts, it's giving me controller prompts. Okay, so here's what I wanna see. So like, okay. So yeah, holding W just goes straight throttle, but then I should be able to just slightly feather the gas. Yeah, it works. It's hard, like the one thing though is that since the travel distance is actually here to there, like that's what, I mean, 5 millimeters or something? Like it's really not much. What's it called? Wootility, that is the best name.
That's pretty good.
For software. Oh, okay. So you've got like an RGB layout, which is great. You can like fully customize where your RGB goes, but you've got these digital profiles and analog profiles. And so these analog profiles are what I was talking about earlier, where I said that you can change where exactly the height is for the actuation on everything. Dark theme, every time. Oh, you can remap everything. That's actually pretty cool too. And then you can change the actuation point. So if I go there, I open like a notepad. Yeah, so I'm barely pressing it. I'm barely pressing it and it comes up. So if I go back to like 3.6 millimeters, yeah, I gotta push a lot further. Okay. Oh, you can create profiles too. So you have to switch it in software instead of just a little toggle on the keyboard, which would actually be pretty cool. Yeah, I don't see anything.
That's how macro views.
Oh, okay. I mean, they're changing the RGB. So yeah, it looks like they are changing the profile, but like, I don't see that represented in the software. I don't know what these are doing. It might just be RGB modes. Yeah, it feels okay. Like having less range feels like a normal keyboard, I guess, where I'm just kind of pressing it all the way down and not really feathering it all that much. Like, it's weird how much this feels more comfortable to me than trying to like feather it properly. So I'm gonna swap out, change it to all the way down to 1.5 millimeters. I really wish you could change it to like zero. This feels okay. Again, I think my main problem overall with this thing is that like, it's not easy to feather keys. Cause that's just your finger pressing down on this thing, especially with a higher, actuation force, I guess? When it's like way too hard to press a key down. I mean, these are like 60 grams or something, so it's not too bad. One other big downside to this keyboard is that you can only swap it with other Lekker switches. I mean, I think that the learning curve on this to try to actually get that proper, you know, ability to feather on and off, I think it's pretty high, to be perfectly honest. All of your keyboard instinct is just press. Press all the way down. That's where you want to go. It's an okay keyboard. I just think that if you're trying to buy it for a purely analog experience, it's more of something you're gonna end up just like playing around with for 10 minutes and then setting it to whatever you want it to actually actuate on. Even when driving in dirt, it didn't feel natural for me to just feather on half of it because you naturally, like there's too much pressure. On a thumbstick, there's a lot more control with your thumb. Like your thumb is a much like meatier finger, right? Like we do a lot of stuff with it. Whereas your fingers are kind of delicate in comparison. I don't know, maybe the space bar. No, even the space bar, it just doesn't feel right. It's like it always wants to push down or push up. It doesn't want to meet me in the middle. So this is going to really appeal to someone who thinks that they're going to get an edge by having this analog input on a keyboard rather than feeling like they're forced to use a controller to get there. If you're so hardcore that you've got a steering wheel and gas pedal, at that point, you're not going to buy this thing. You're just going to buy a better racing rig. But I think if you want to actually use these the way they're intended for like proper analog use, they need to up the stem another 3-4 millimeters to give you finer control. Yeah, that's the problem. It's like analog, but not analog enough. Thanks for watching, everyone. This is the Wooting 2HE. It's not bad. A couple $100. I don't know. I would get something else, but I think it definitely appeals to a bunch of people out there. If you like this video, it's not a TKL, but you can check out Linus's review of the Logitech TKL. That was a nice keyboard, especially if you like Logitech and you don't want to build your own custom board, because we all know that's way too expensive.